to realize is that discouragement is bold. Discouragement is bold. So bold that it can enter into the church. It is so bold that it can climb the pulpit and stand. It is so bold that it can enter the highest office in the country. It does not matter who you are. If discouragement is set after you, you can come to church. You can dance all you can. You can jump all you can. You can get excited as you can. As far as you don't know and will do what you are ought to do, you will go back home and discouragement will stand and stare at you. As far as I'm concerned, you may be the first lady of the nation. It does not matter your title, your position, and where you belong in life. If you don't know how to deal with discouragement, it will follow you anywhere. It will follow you to the White House. It will follow you to the government house. It will follow you to the bank. It will follow you everywhere. And as long, as far as you don't know how to keep it where it belongs, it will shrink you. Have you not seen somebody who is so rich, so elegant, and yet is dying of illness? Have you not seen people who have so much, yet they can't sleep at night? They have a bed that up to tons of millions. But yet when they lie down on that bed and they remember the issues of life, when they lie down on that bed and they remember where Satan has brought them, when they lie on that bed and they remember the thing that goes on around them, they get discouraged. I don't know who's here tonight that Satan has vowed that you are not going to find happiness. As far as God is concerned, we serve a living God. We don't serve a dead God. When men are saying no, we are saying yes. If God say yes, nobody can say no. For our God is a faithful God. He is a just God. And I decree there will be no more discouragement. It is bold. It follows us even into choir. You see a lot of women sitting down here and dancing, jubilating and shouting. But only God knew how many of them are having marital issues. Only God knows how many of them are crying for the fruit of the womb. Only God knows how many of them come to church dressed in powder and cosmetic, look so elegant, and yet when they go home at night, they cannot sleep. Only God knows how many of them, their husbands are abusing them emotionally, and because of the way he's highly placed in the church, they can't even come to open up, not even to the pastor. Who told you discouragement is afraid of you? Who told you discouragement select who he deals with? As far as crisis is concerned, if you are not ready to make up your mind, if you are not ready to keep it down, if you are not ready to make it straight, if you are not ready to bury you, it will bury you. But today, because you are here, because you have an appointment, because it is a time for rain, it is a time for abundance, it is a time for favor, we come again every spirit of discouragement. How can you call upon the name of the Lord and yet Satan wants to swallow you? How can you call upon the name of the Lord and yet Satan wants to destroy you? Because of time, I would like to rush through to what I have tonight. To have divine favor and reign of abundance is the best thing that can happen to any Christian. To have a time of abundance, living affluence, is the best thing, because that was God's original plan for us as Christians. But things are beginning to unfold. It did not just start here. It started back way from the Bible. And that is why some of us find ourselves where we were. Because what God had in mind was not for Adam and Eve to fall in the poor place. Because for each time God make a provision, he also make a place of comfort for us. But what happened is that we go after the provision, we never know how to maintain the comfort. As long as you do not know how to maintain what God has kept for you, as long as you don't know how to stay out what he has prepared for you, as long as you don't know how to guard and protect what he has prepared for you, Satan that is fighting you is not emotional. The enemy that is after you does not care whether you are beautiful, tall or short. The Satan that wants to destroy you does not care from where you are coming from. He has been there, he has been attacking you, and if he was going down today, you gotta make up your mind to stand up and look him in the face and say, it does not matter my background, it does not matter blessing. It does not matter what is my lineage. It does not matter what I'm married for. It does not matter what is happening in my husband's family. As far as I am concerned, I am a different person. I carry a mark of honor. Satan cannot deal with me. I need to go. This is a season and time when God is looking for women who know how to carry the mark. Without the mark of honor, Satan will crush you. Without your mark of honor, he will destroy your family. Without the mark of honor, he will finish you. Reign and abundance and favor is our divine inheritance. It is what he has promised us. It is what me and you want to walk into it, because it is our right. Have you paid for an aircraft and they ever stop you from entering? Because it is your life. It is your money. The ticket has been given to you. The answer is your heart. But if only you know how to preserve your comfort. What happened to us is when we come into Christ, we get excited. We get carried away. And we forget the place of preserving our comfort. Where is your mind?